Well, a new generation of pop stars and some old ones have released a newly recorded version of the Band-Aid song, Do They Know It's Christmas? 30 years after the original, it's raising money to fight the Ebola crisis in Africa. But the song has raised controversy. Take a listen to some of it.
Wear a kiss so long can kill you. And there's death in every tear. And the Christmas bells that ring there are the clanging chimes of doom.
Clanging chimes of doom. Well, African artists have recorded another song called Africa Stop Ebola. It's designed to raise awareness about the epidemic and raise funds to fight it. Well, Carlos Chirinos wrote those lyrics. He joins me now from London. He's a professor at New York University. Just tell us about this Band-Aid song. The motives behind it are to raise money, but many Africans see it as patronizing. What do you think?
Well, I think any initiative to raise funds for the Ebola crisis are valuable and commendable. The problem is that the type of narrative that the song is creating is probably going to do more damage than the money it's going to raise. As you heard in the lyrics of the song, there is a moment where it says, the only hope they have tonight is to survive. And this is a way in which is portraying Africa as a whole, and this is problematic. I think they're failing to see the actual cultural value of a song and how long it's going to survive, to live on. And this message will be repeated again and again. So in the future, this affects Africa, it affects tourism, it affects trade. And this is not what Africa needs. What Africa needs is support from the bottom up. It needs the West to understand that the entirety of the continent is not the way it is portrayed, and it is a continent where hope is actually alive.
Okay, so, you know, Bob Geldof was brought onto a television program in the UK to address some of the criticism, and he used very colourful language. In fact, was taken off air in response to it. Many people who buy the album say, listen, we're trying to make a difference, even the artists. Saying this is raising money. So a lot of people can't understand why it's insulting to the people it's supposed to help.
Well, again, I think it is repeating an old model, which is throw money at a problem, hoping that the problem will go away. And it is true that this crisis requires a lot of money. But put this picture in perspective. It's like sending more firemen to put out a fire. That's what the money is used for. Sending firemen. Now the problem, the real problem is prevention, is the way in which the disease is passed on from a human to human. And this is not being addressed in the song. It is, and again, the value of the song it is aimed at the West, the way in which it's portraying the West, in which it's portraying Africa, is quite denigrant and quite, it's not really a positive message to be sending about the entirety of the continent. And we're seeing that already. We're seeing a knock-on effect on tourism, in fact. I was looking at pictures in South Africa, in Zimbabwe, empty hotels, because no one in the West, especially when they listen to a song like this, would like to go on holidays next year to Africa. And this is a serious problem.
You've written a song about Ebola for African musicians. What did you do differently? How do you think this is the way it should be done?
Well, I quite not wrote the song entirely. I did advise the lyrics and how to go about it. Now, the aim of that song, of Africa Stop Ebola, is twofold. Is to raise awareness among West African populations about what they need to do in order to actually stop Ebola. So it's about prevention. It's really about engaging in an active change of behaviors associated with Ebola transmission. And the second message is hope. Because really, in order to get out of this crisis, what Africans need is hope. What people need is hope. So, yes, we're also looking to raise funds, and this is important. Again, I keep repeating this. It is important to raise funds. It's important that people continue to contribute. But the main issue at stake here is stopping the disease at ground zero. And that involves a change in behaviors. And this is what this song is trying to do, is change behaviors associated with Ebola transmission.
Okay, Carlos Chirinos, a professor at New York University in music, thank you very much for joining us and giving us your opinion. And just to remind viewers, it looks like that Band-Aid Ebola single is one of the chart toppers on iTunes. Let's move on to another story that has authorities in the States.